Hello all, welcome to channel 11. And before going to actual video, I would like to thank you all for your support and encouragement. And goodbye to 2019 and welcome to 2020. So now we have reached around 500 subscribers and we have been added around 300 plus videos. Without your support, it could not be possible. Thank you and keep watching my videos and encourage us. Thank you all. Hello all, welcome to channel 11. Today I'm going to give some presentation about the events. And I'll give some demo about how to publish the event, how to subscribe to those events. This is very simple example. Coming to the example, so this is my simple example. So I have the publisher class and I have the subscribers. So this is the publisher. It's going to publish the events and these are the subscribers which are going to subscribe those events. So whenever call the raiser, whenever publisher raise the events, so automatically those information will automatically reach to the whoever is subscribed. So this information and this example I brought it from the Microsoft Docs. So I whenever I need some information, I will go to the docs and I'll keep reading and do some practice. So I will recommend Microsoft Docs to you also if required. And let me go to the example step by step. So this is my main method. So as I mentioned, so this is my publisher class, these are two subscriber class. So here I am subscribing this publisher events with information subscriber 1, subscribe 2. So I'll go inside this class and I will explain one step by step. And here I am raising. And let me go to the publisher class. This is my publisher class. Publish the events. Class that publishes an event. So this is my publisher class. If you say this is my event declaration. If you see that my event declarations, this is the syntax. So it should be public and event. And event handler, this is the generic event handler delegate. This is a generic event handler delegate. It will accept the arguments. These are the my custom arguments. If you see this, this is the custom arguments. So custom arguments will help us to pass some extra information as in arguments. So first of all, this is my syntax way of declaring the custom event args. So class should be inherited by the event args. And so for the sake of demo, I am accepting as a string. And so user can pass string and I am holding that string into my private variable. This is the event arguments, custom event arguments. So this arguments I am passing to my delegate. So it's optional. Suppose if you don't want to pass anything, we can ignore this one. If you go to delegate, you can see the syntax here. So this is the .NET 2.0 onwards. So we can use this syntax. So we have another option. We can define our own delegate and implement same functionality, but I am using generic event handler. So I have declared my event here with arguments, custom arguments, and in my method. So I have defined one custom method that is called do something. See, in do something I am raising the events. So here I am created one more method and I am passing some information, my custom arguments. In before raising event, it's up to us. We can write our own code. So see, this is optional. If you want to, write some your own code, you can write here in this line before raising event. So if I go to my onRaise custom event method, if you see here, this is the my onRaise custom event method. It's accepting custom arguments, and here I am assigning my event to my generic delegate. So I am assigning that event to here. And once I assign my event to delegate, so I can raise that event. So before raising event, I need to verify whether my handler is null or not. If it is null, we should ignore. So when it's going to null means, suppose if there is no any subscriber, the handler will be null. So we should check that before raising event. So this is how we can check if handler does not null, and I'm sending some extra information to my arguments, custom arguments, and I am raising the event. So handler off. This means this one, delegate, and passing arguments. This is how my publisher will work. So I am publishing this event and I am raising this event here. So publishing and raising. So this is very simple code, and once my publishers are ready, so subscribers, I will go to subscriber class here. If you see the subscriber, it has a constructor, it's accepting ID and publisher object. So it's up to us. If you want to do some extra code, some calculations and all, we can do it. And in subscriber, if you see that I'm accepting publisher class. In publisher class, here subscribe is going to subscribing the publisher event. This is how we can subscribe those events. So raise event is our event, declared event, and I am creating handler here. So this is also C# 2.0 syntax. This is how we can subscribe the event. So once, suppose if the publisher raised, this code will automatically will get work automatically. This event will, subscriber will automatically notify something happened from the publisher side. So here it is going to notifying here, and we can get those information, whatever publisher sending information we will get from here. So as an argument, from the arguments we can get the subscriber message. So this is the subscriber implementation. So if we go for now I will go for main method. If you see here, this is my publisher. I am creating object publisher, and in my subscriber I have subscriber 1. So in my subscriber I am passing some information, some string, and publisher class object. If you go for publisher, so I am raising event here, subscribing my event here, same thing subscriber 2 also I am doing. And whenever publisher raise the event, those changes will automatically notify these two subscribers. So let me go and run and see how it is going. So I'll go one by one by pressing F10. Line by line I can check how it is executing. Friends, before going to complete this, I will show you one thing. Recently I notify WhatsApp also we can able to check our message from the desk from the desktop also, I mean computer also. So how it is going to be? First of all, so this is my WhatsApp. So I am accessing from my laptop. So you can try also, we have the web app in so once you install your app in your mobile application, we have option called web app. So we have one exe available, so you need to download that exe into your laptop in the laptop, and you need to install that web app WhatsApp web app exe. Once you install that, and if I can, let me go and log out here. So this is at initial it is going to be looks like this. So in your mobile, if you already installed WhatsApp, WhatsApp in your mobile, so it is saying that to use WhatsApp on your computer, top menu settings and select WhatsApp web. So you have to go to our WhatsApp and there is a WhatsApp menu, three dots. If you click that, we have the menu will contain WhatsApp web. If you show this code to your mobile, so it will automatically read and get authenticated, and from there onwards you can able to access your WhatsApp from your laptop. So it is easy, you can easily type whatever you want from the keyboard, and you can download attachment, you can add attachments. I think it's very useful, and so other than keep on going check our mobiles for WhatsApp message and all, you can see from here. It's time saving, I can say. So now going to our example, so it got I put the debug here. Let me go and so here the shortcuts are same, so I need to use this one. So bear with me some time. Want to go inside. So I'll put debug here. So it came to subscriber. So subscriber, I'm passing string ID as well as publisher object. Let me go. And so I have been subscribed. Now same thing for subscriber one also. And now it is going to that publisher, and I'm raising the event. Call this method that raises the event. It's going to, and if you see here, if you see handler, it is because it's already subscribed. It has two subscribers. So that way it is not null. And so it has been raised. So subscriber one has already subscribed. So event has been raised, and it has been notified to subscriber one. If you see that, this is my subscriber notified. If you see. So this is subscriber one, Sorry for this message, and this is for a second subscriber already subscribed, so it has been notified to him also. And now I am it's all everything has been done. Now if you see here, subscriber received this message, so this message has been sent by the publisher. So this is how we can do implement events, and so this is one of the example for how to implement publishing and subscriber example. I hope you enjoy this example, and I think you get some information how to install and access WhatsApp from our laptops. Thanks for your time, and once again thanks for all your support, and keep watching my channel. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.